What you've done as you go through life is made choices. You've chosen to go to university or not, to get married or not, have kids or not, travel or not. You have made lifestyle choices to smoke or not, exercise or not. You've had good and bad things happen to you, maybe a car accident, maybe the experience of a great success in a career. So by the time you get to be 80 and you've made all these unique choices and had a variety of things happen to you, then your persona, your brain, your personality, your social networks, everything is quite unique. That's why, in the realm of, say, statistics or personality, older adult populations have a greater standard deviation. There is no such thing as a typical 70-year-old. So, with increasing age, people get more and more different from each other. We say there is increased heterogeneity with increasing age. And this is the second key gerontology principle. For this reason, older adults are a great population to study because there's a lot of variation in the population. This is why, if you gave a test to a room full of 30-year-olds and a room full of 80-year-olds, the 80-year-olds would have a much wider range of responses, whether you gave them a memory test or personality test, or even just asked them, what's your favorite flavor of ice cream? Time and experience add up to heterogeneity.